Hey guys, what's up, and welcome to Love Inspiree's space on the internet. Oftentimes we find ourselves choosing partners that tell us everything that we want to hear. We find ourselves running away from the people that are really going to add value to our lives. Stick around as I discuss three things you need to be looking for when choosing the right partner. Things that are unpopular and that nobody is going to talk about. Let's talk love. Hey guys, welcome back or welcome to Love Inspiree's YouTube channel. For those who don't know, my name is Angie and I'm the founder of Love Inspiree, where our mission is to build more powerful, transparent, and durable relationships. As I said in the opening, today we're talking about choosing the right partner. Now, 2 weeks ago, I did a video on this where I discussed the steps to choosing the right partner. I talked about the good things, but in this video, I want to get down to what we call the bad things. But these are very essential bad things. The first thing that I want to discuss is choosing the right partner is not just about choosing somebody that is going to be all hunky-dory, tell you everything you want to hear.
Nope.
Choosing the right partner is also about somebody that is going to give it to you straight. Somebody that's going to give it to you real. And we all have that one person in our life that's going to tell us things that won't always sound pretty to us. The first thing that you should be looking for when choosing the right partner is someone who is going to hold you accountable.
Yeah.
Remember that someone who doesn't remind you when you need to take responsibility for a situation does not truly care about you. They don't care about you, and they don't care about the way that you look in front of people. A good wife, a good husband is always going to be mindful of how their significant other looks in front of somebody. So don't be upset when your partner tries to correct you or hold you accountable for something. For example, if you treat somebody poorly or if you say something that you shouldn't say, your partner corrects you. They're holding you accountable. And this is only going to make you a better person, a better boss, a better son, daughter, whatever leadership role you're in. The second thing you should be looking for when choosing the right partner is someone who is going to elevate and teach you. Now, here's the tricky thing. A lot of us don't like to be taught. We think we know everything, right?
Yeah.
I'm sure you know this person. I'm sure you may be married to this person or in a relationship with this person. But this is not a good trait to have. And you should never, ever push your significant other away because they are trying to teach you. Don't let your unhealthy ego get so high that you miss these vital, important statements that your partner is trying to make. These meetings and teachings that they're trying to give you. This is only going to help you grow as an individual. And when you grow as an individual, you grow as a couple. Remember that. The only way that you're going to get to a happy and healthy relationship is when you learn to grow together. And this is part of the process, guys. And the last thing that I want to talk about is you want a partner who is going to tell you things you don't want to hear. Kind of like I'm doing right now. I'm telling you to look out for these qualities that you may have in your mind that you've been programmed to believe are bad when they're really not. You want somebody that is going to pick at you in a good way. Somebody that is going to give you the tools you need to think outside of the box, right? So my husband, you know, one of the things that I love about my husband is he always challenges me to give people the benefit of the doubt. When I go on a rant, so-and-so meant this, or so-and-so said that, I know what they meant, I know this, that, and a third. My husband always brings me back to reality and says, well, maybe they were having a bad day, or maybe they didn't mean it how you want it meant, or how you thought it was meant to be. But nonetheless, even though I don't like what he's saying at the moment, he is making me better. He is challenging me to think outside of the box, to give people the benefit of the doubt. And it's only gonna help me be a better wife and a better person and a better Christian. And of course, run my business the best way. You know, if I have employees one day, I need to be able to give them the benefit of the doubt. If they call out, maybe they really are sick. You never truly know. So you always have to be willing to give people the benefit of the doubt. And that's something, just an example that I love about my husband. But you definitely wanna find a partner that is going to tell you things you wanna hear. You may have that partner in your life right now. It may be a best friend that can tell you anything. And it can be something that you truly, truly don't want to hear. You're like, oh my goodness, why she say that? I can't stand her for saying that. Blah, 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 whatever the case may be. But in the end, you appreciate that. And when you have a partner where you can appreciate the information that you don't want to hear, that's when you know you have chose the right person in your life. Ultimately, you want somebody that's going to tell you what other people are scared to tell you. To close, what I'm truly trying to say is you want a partner that is going to challenge you. Challenge you in a good way. Challenge you to elevate. Challenge your mind to think, like I said earlier, outside of the box. This will help your relationship stay positive. You know, when we continue to focus on the negative things, when we continue to focus on these things that I just discussed as negatives, you're never going to find the value in it. And this will help your relationship stay positive. This will help your relationship stay moving in the right direction. Remember, you always want to go up. If you ever find yourself going backwards in a relationship, that's when you know you need to do some serious, serious work. You always want to be elevating in your relationship. And these are the tools that I just gave you that are going to elevate your relationship. The second thing that this will do for your relationship is help with conflict management, which ultimately leads to good communication skills. When you are telling your partner something about themselves, that maybe they treated somebody else wrong, it's an evaluation. It's a time to self-reflect. And then when you are self-reflecting, you may find an instance where you have offended your partner and you can come back and apologize to them. That's conflict management. So always remember that when you are telling your partner something about themselves, make sure you are also doing it out of love. Make sure you are not doing it to be spiteful or doing it to one-up them in a situation or because they may have did it to you yesterday. Do everything in love. All right, guys, that's all I have for you today in Choosing the Right Partner Part 2. We talked about choosing somebody that's gonna hold you accountable, somebody that's gonna make you take responsibility for your actions. We talked about someone that's going to teach and elevate you. Listen, you will never stop learning in your relationships, and you should definitely want a partner that's going to teach you, that's constantly teaching you, that you can learn from. And the third thing we talked about is someone who's ultimately going to tell you things that you don't want to hear, things that other people are scared to tell you. These are the three things that you want to watch for in a partner, along with all the other things that I talked about. These are good characteristic traits from people, guys. Now, of course, there is a fine line because you don't want it to be too narcissistic. But when you have a balance of respect and then these three things, you have a great, great relationship. So don't take those things and look at them as bad, or this person is nitpicking you, or they have they're trying to find something wrong with you. They're trying to find greatness in you and pull that out. So stick on and hold on to those people.
Yeah.
Guys, if you want to talk one-on-one to me, feel free to hit me up at www.loveinspiree.com/services, where I will most certainly be happy to talk to you about all your relationship needs and concerns. And we can dig a little deeper into this if you're having this problem and want to discuss your situation more in depth. I'll see you guys all in the next video, and you guys have a blessed, blessed Wednesday. Talk to you soon.